Hello and welcome to this tutorial. In this video, you will learn how to navigate 25 Live. This is part one in a two-part series. To access 25 Live, go to SharePoint, Academic Affairs, look to the right of the screen and scroll down to the links section where you will find two links. One is labeled 25 Live Login Prod, and the other is labeled 25 Live Login Test. The test link is the sandbox where you can learn how to navigate and use 25 Live. The prod link is our live production server where you will submit all of your space requests. In this video, I will be using the live production server. To sign into 25 Live, use the same username and password that you use for R25. There are two links available, one in the lower left corner of the screen and one in the upper right. If you have forgotten your password, type in your username and click the Forgot Your Password link. Otherwise, enter your password and click on the Sign In button. The system will take a few seconds to load your information. Depending on the security settings that are set by your system administrator, your screen may appear slightly different than the one presented in this video. After signing in, you can set your own user preferences. This includes the date and time, you can change your password, or update your contact information. To copy yourself on any email you send, click Edit Your Contact Information under Preferences. Next, click Email and click Copy Myself on All Emails I Send at the bottom of the window and click Save. For help, click the Help button located in the upper right corner of the browser window to open the 25 Live User Manual. Please note you must be logged in to view it. You can also click the help icon, which is indicated by the question mark found throughout 25 Live for context-sensitive help. The 25 Live footer contains the following links on every page. The icon legend displays a list of icons that are used throughout 25 Live. The email feedback link allows you to send email directly to the scheduling office. The address is scheduling@gwinnetttech.edu. Help tips can be enabled or disabled, and the text size can be increased or decreased. To open an item in the last view that you used, you can left-click on the name. In this example, I will click the Events tab and left-click on the name of one of the items in a previous search. In this case, the event opens in the Detail view. You can also right-click the name to select the view from the list. Choosing a view from the list will load that item using that selected view. In this example, I will select the calendar view. Start items can include events, locations, resources, and organizations. Starring items allow quick access to items you work with on a regular basis. Contacts may be starred or unstarred in the Events Wizard only. Likewise, event types may be starred or unstarred within the Events Wizard only. From the 25 Live Home tab dashboard, you can perform a quick search for events, locations, or resources. Enter keywords or a partial word or an event reference number to search. Searches are not case sensitive and the results will be displayed under the appropriate tab. In this example, I will search for the keyword meeting in the events quick search box. As you'll notice, the results were opened in the events tab. Let's go back to the Homepage tab and try a location search. In this example, I will enter a partial location name, 100, followed by a space and 20. This search result opens in the Locations tab and returns results for all classrooms in Building 100 on the 200 hall. This concludes part one of the tutorial on how to navigate 25 Live. In part two, I will cover how to navigate tabs in greater detail. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.